There have been a ton of people in the comments asking me about how to install Steam and enable Steam Play. So I figured I'd dedicate an episode towards just that. Hi, I'm Gardiner, and welcome to another episode of Linux Literate. While installing Steam is generally pretty easy, I'll say this straight up. You'll have the easiest time getting everything up and running with Ubuntu, or one of its derivatives like Linux Mint or Elementary. Or you can use Manjaro, which actually comes with Steam pre-installed, but that's a bit more of an advanced OS. Not to toot my own horn or anything. If you already have Steam installed, you can skip ahead to here, or here, or somewhere ahead. There's a time code on the screen. You can just be smart with it. I don't know. Installing software on Linux is much easier and safer than it is on Windows, but it's also different. In the Windows world, going to a website and installing some random executable is commonplace. On Linux, yeah, not so much. So instead, we get our software from the distribution maintainer, from something called a repository, or a repo for short. The first step to installing Steam is opening your software center. It might be called something like Software Center on other distros, but on Ubuntu, it's called Ubuntu Software. Now, you can search for Steam from here. If Steam doesn't show up in your search, you may need to add additional repositories to your system. On Ubuntu, open the Software and Updates app, and check the box Software Restricted by Copyright, Multiverse. This gives you access to Steam as well as several other proprietary apps right through your package manager. Now go back to your software center and find Steam. Once it's installed, you should be able to launch it from GNOME, or whatever you use. Now, if you're having trouble at this point, leave a comment below and the community and I will try to help. So now we have Steam installed. So what should we do from this point? Well, if you want to be able to play your games, open Steam. Once it's open, you'll want to click Steam in the top left corner and then choose Settings. On the Account tab under Beta Participation, you'll want to click the Change button. On this screen, you'll need to opt into the Steam Beta Update channel, then click OK. You'll be prompted to restart, and Steam will automatically download the beta version for you. Once Steam is booted up again, you'll have access to any of the whitelisted games Valve have certified as working with Steam Play. They'll appear as normal SteamOS or Linux games, and you won't need to do anything else to play them. But if you want to try games that are not whitelisted, and I say try here because there's absolutely no guarantee that they'll work in any way, shape, or form, then continue onwards, my friend, at your own peril! Okay, that might have been a bit dramatic. Alright, let's go back into the settings. Click on the Steam Play tab, and now check Enable Steam Play for all titles. You'll be prompted to restart Steam again, and when you do, all the Windows games in your library will be available for you to download and try. I'll link to resources below that can help you determine what, if anything, you can do to get some non-whitelisted games running. If you have a question, feel free to leave it below and we'll all try to help. But what do you think? How has Steam Play worked for you? Leave me a comment and let me know, or hit me up on Twitter at The Linux Gamer. If you believe in the work that I do, you can support the show with a monthly contribution over on Patreon, or you can pick up a t-shirt, there's a link below. But no matter what you do, whether it's hitting that like button or sharing this video with your friends, don't forget to subscribe to see more from me, The Linux Gamer. And as always, thanks for watching.